Hey folks, Dan, Hardwood Hollow Bushcraft here. This is an intro video I'm going to shoot for an upcoming series on tree cutting, specifically felling of trees. And I plan on addressing both, modern, using chainsaws, modern techniques, as well as old school techniques using saws and axes. So just wanted to give you an idea. I'm going to spin around here so that you can see the woods and point out some of the trees that I got to take down. The main reason I got to take these trees down is because right behind me, over my shoulder, actually over that shoulder I should say, is the house, and a number of these trees that you can see out here are actually close enough, and when there's leaves on them — there's no leaves on them right now, they're just starting to bud — but when there's leaves on them and we get heavy winds, they blow towards the house. And as you can see, they are big trees, some of them closer here, and pretty much any one of these trees, if the wind blew them towards the house — they're big oaks — could come down and hit the house and cause a considerable amount of damage, which I don't want. So plus this area over here, where most of these trees are, at some point in the near future, hopefully — I do intend on building a workshop, and that's the area where I want the workshop to be, kind of out in this area here. So this is doing double duty: take those trees down so they don't hit the house, and prepping the area for my workshop. So just wanted to give you this quick intro, and then I'll be shooting this series of videos based on taking some of these trees down. Like I said, covering both new school and old school, or I should say modern with chainsaws, and old school axe, saw, and wedging techniques, showing you how to fell trees. A lot of the bushcraft videos I see don't really cover that, other than cutting of very small things. I want to address the work involved and the techniques involved in getting a tree to fall where you want it, as close as you can. Trees have their own nature, and they're going to want to go where the weight of the top of the tree, the angle of the tree — like this tree right here is at a pretty severe angle, so it's going to go where it wants to go. But I can help kind of tip it in my favor a little bit, because what you want to really avoid is getting it hung up. So like that tree right there, this one right here that I just showed you, when it goes, it's going to want to fall and hit this tree right here, which you can't see from this angle, but that tree is actually — I'm sorry, this tree right here — and that tree is actually forked. That tree's going to want to fall and hit that tree, but by wedging it just right at the base, just to the right of where that — just to the right of where that X is right there, I can nudge it where I want it to go without having to try and get a rope around it to pull it. And the problem with that is that these trees go up very high before the branches begin to fork off, which makes it very difficult to get a rope around it up high to be able to nudge it where you want it without actually climbing the tree first. And I'm almost 50, and I don't climb trees the way I used to. So I'm not afraid of heights. I'm just afraid of hitting the ground. I don't bounce the way I used to. So we try and do things the easy way when we can. You'll see I'm also going to employ the use of my tractor here and there to nudge a tree down. I shot video of when I cut that tree down. I have to do the editing process on it, and you'll see that I utilized my tractor, I utilized chains, because that tree right there also hung up on that tree that I showed you, and you can see here some of the logs from that. That's a poplar, and it fell into the fork of this tree, which is where I wanted it to go, but before it went into the fork, it got hung up at the top. So it took a little bit of creative engineering to get it to go down right where I wanted it, but that made it much easier to cut all these logs up with the majority of the tree suspended up off the ground. All right. We'll continue with the series as I get more cut, and we'll pick it up then. All right. This is Dan. I'm out.
Storm clouds are building above the timberline. The lightning's flashing across the mountainside. The thunder's rolling down the canyons that is mine. Somewhere beyond the great divide. The bugle of the bull elk echoes through the pines. The north wind moans her lonesome lullaby. He hungers for the freedom of an eagle as she glides. Somewhere beyond the great divide. He's heard the call of the wild. He's heard the call of the wild. The mountains call him to him like a mother calls her child. He's heard the call of the wild. Living in the city, for kids to be a grind. Putting in his hours, working overtime. Waiting for the day he can leave it all behind. To go somewhere beyond the great divide. He's got to get away from this city for a while. He's got to answer the call of the wild.